Good morning, children. Hope you are fine. Children, please take out your literature book. Today, I will teach a poem, At Sea in the House, page 51. I repeat, page 51, At Sea in the House. Let me recite it. When I pretend them to be, the tables and chairs are land, where you can safely stand, and the carpet between is sea. The dining table makes a boat, and I climb on there by way of the rocking chair, and out to sea we float. The pattern in the carpet swims like fish on the floor, and anyone opening the door is sure to get very wet. Children, now I am going to explain the poem line wise. Children, do you play with the toys? Yes, we all play with the toys. No, and especially boys, they play with the toy cars, and the girls, they play with the dolls, isn't it? Yes. And you imagine your toys to be something else. Am I correct? Yes. Like, for example, girls, when they play with the dolls, they imagine the dolls to be their children. Am I correct, children? Yes, that's true. Okay, let's start. First stanza, when I pretend them to be, the tables and chairs are land, where you can safely stand, and the carpet between is sea. It means, actually, this is a poem about a small boy, okay, who pretend that the table and chair in his house are land, where he can safely stand and carpet is sea. Okay, did you understand? Next stanza, the dining table makes a boat and I climb on there by way of the rocking chair and out to sea we float. It means, the boy imagines the dining table to be a boat where he can climb. And the poet uses the rocking chair so that he can move slowly on the surface of water. The third stanza is, the pattern in the carpet swims like fish on the floor, and anyone opening the door is sure to get very wet. It means, the boy imagines the carpet in his house has designs of fish that are swimming on the floor, and anyone opens the door is surely will get wet. Okay, did you understand the poem? Now, let's move to the word meanings, children. Our first word meaning is imagined. It means formed a picture in your mind of what something might be like. Next is pretend, to imagine that something is true as a part of a game. Float, to move slowly on the surface of water. Pattern means design. Okay, now listen to the instruction which I am going to give you. First of all, you will take out your literature fair copy. You will write down the poem very nicely with the poet's name. Next page, you will write down the word meanings which are given below. And now, I will move to the question answers. Okay, so listen carefully. First, write down in your fair copy, in the rough copy, and then you make it fair. Okay? Okay, now let's start. Read this line and answer the questions that follow. The dining table makes a boat and I climb on there by way of the rocking chair. Onto what does the speaker climb? Your answer is, the speaker climbs on the dining table. The speaker climbs on the dining table. Question number B. Why do you think the speaker uses a rocking chair? Your answer is, the speaker uses a rocking chair so that he can move to the floor. I repeat, the speaker uses a rocking chair so that he can move to the floor. Where does the speaker imagine the boat will go? Your answer is, the speaker imagines the boat will go out to sea. The speaker imagines the boat will go out to sea. Number three, the speaker says anyone will get wet if they enter the room. Why? The speaker says anyone will get wet if they enter the room because he imagined the room to be sea. He imagined the room to be sea. Okay. Question number four. Do you think the person imagining the things mentioned in the poem is a child or a grown-up? Why do you think so? Your answer is, I think the person imagining the things mentioned in the poem is a child because he is an innocent boy. Now, these question answers, first you write down in the rough copy and then you make it fair. And when school will reopen, children, I will do the correction. And do your work very neatly. Thank you, children.